This is A Whiter Shade of Pale Explained. One can simply find the song online. Whiter Shade of Pale is a song of the English rock band Procol Harum, written in the year 1967. More than 10 million copies were sold. There is a lot of analysis what is the song about, which uses a lot of symbols. It is mentioned that the text is about a drunken temptation or a metaphor for death caused by some drug abuse. The writer of the song said that he was at a party and he had heard that a man said to a woman, "You've gone a whiter shade of pale." I'm gonna try to explain all the symbols of the song. So, what is this song about? It is easy to understand the first verse. There was a party. Fandango is a slow Spanish dance. They skipped the slow part, so they were quite elated. Mentioning the floor and the ceiling means that the party filled totally the place, turning it upside down. They asked more, and then the waiter brought a tray. And there comes the refrain. Partly, the words slow down the story, and partly the words indicate that the following cannot be speak out directly. White like a miller or white like a miller's apprentice are English sayings. So there wasn't drinks on the tray brought by the waiter, but something really whiting. And as they used it, so the miller told his tale, then she's gonna white her shade of pale. I think it was cocaine or some similar substance according to the following verses. Using this substance, so as the miller told its tale, her face turned ghostly a whiter shade of pale. After that he was scared, but she said that there is no reason to be afraid. It was not new to her to use that miller, and she knew his tales. He talked about what to do. The one of 16 Vestal virgins leaving the coast is a huge mystery since the appearance of the song. In the film The Commitments by Alan Parker, a man asked what that mean. And the priest said that he also never understood that.
Great intro, huh? They nicked it from Marvin Gaye.
He nicked it from Bach.
Oh, it's beautiful. Poxiest bleeding lyrics ever written.
When the 16 Vestal virgins leave for the coast, what's that mean? I never understood that either.
By the way, this movie is about a band which members unfortunately had lack of enough commitment to make music to bring soul to Dublin, so they fell apart. Coast is the border between land and sea. I think here sea means days caused by some substance. The land is the safe ground, that is the normal state of mind. Obviously virgin refers to innocence. And the expression 16-year-old virgin could also mean a line, namely the edge of childhood innocence. The words are not about years, but it is possible that here the word Vestal appears as a replacement for the year old. 16 Vestal Virgins, 16-year-old virgins. If the text would mention 16-year-old virgin, it would be quite questionable. So he hesitated which card of the possibilities he play out. And he did not want to let her go to the shore between the innocence and the heavy use of the substance. Although his eyes were open, he did not want to see as she loses her innocence. It's important that there are two other verses which are excluded from the well-known version of the song. What about the following symbols? In the next verse she said that she very well knew the sea and now she was on the mainland, but he thought that the current was should be enough. Like a mirror, he wanted to show her true image. He said that if she knew the sea so well, then maybe it's her home, what means that she was an addict. Evidently his expression, mermaid, hurt her. Neptune is the god of the sea, so here it means a very hard drug. But her smile meant something like that, that was not a pleasant state or a pleasant experience. The refrain comes. Interestingly, now the miller can refer her to, because she is who told her tale. She was ashamed, so she became pale. The fourth verse is not very good. Most of its parts are just making excuses. The first words refer to Shakespeare's play Twelfth Night.
If music be the food of love, play on. If the excess of it that's surfeiting the appetite may sicken and so die.
The looking glass above was his opinion. Now there is a real mirror image where he had stopped reasoning and thought that he should love, not criticize her. In the text, love would be a stronger substance, not only a sea, but an ocean. Thus now, Miller can mean love, who told the tale. So, is this song only about some substance use? The song also appears in lots of movies. Moreover, it can be heard in weddings too. Is it appropriate in weddings or not? Symbols are abstract signs. One specific symbol can be interpreted more than one way. However, its interpretations might be some way similar to each other. System of symbols, such as a song or a movie, has some baseline meanings. But if we put the symbols into another situation, a specific context, that context may revise the meanings of the symbols, thus the meaning of the whole system of symbols. The song also appears in the movie Oblivion. The final pictures of the movie can be interpreted as returning to the very home and family, and can also be interpreted as a near-death or even more a post-death or post-mortem experience. These two interpretations are the same. If the protagonist fights for a better future and humanity, finally his soul can find his inner peace and paradise. The homecoming of Jack is a symbol that has an abstract meaning, thus it can be interpreted in more concrete ways. Symbols are polymorphic. The song A Whiter Shade of Pale appears in the movie Oblivion. Interestingly, the context of the story revives the baseline meaning of the song. In the movie, there are two tales. The first one is told by Beach, the leader of the resistance. In this case, the waiter can be the fate, who brings the plate, but is the chance to save the humanity. And Beach is the miller, who tells his tale. The second tale is told by Julia. In this case, the waiter can be Beach, who brings the plate what is the chance to have a real life. Julia is the miller who tells her tale about another life. This tale is about the possibility of such a way of life for which is worth living, even more for which is worth to die. And this way of life, this way of thinking appears as a ghost or spirit from the past before the memory erases or brainwashing of our modern time. In some languages the words white and bright are very close, a whiter shade, a brighter shade. And in that life the soul would really bright. So is the song only about a drug abuse? Its basic meaning is that, however, its symbols can also be interpreted in another way. We stopped taking things too easy and started taking things very seriously. Maybe it's close to the unbearable, however, we are committed to change our life. Now the miller is a soul guide who has a tale about a chance. Instead of rationalizing that why we don't do something, we recognize the real opportunity and we don't want to lose that. Whilst we are aware of things around, we look into our soul to find the right way. So the song is also about taking something very seriously, for example, as seriously as a marriage. In the movie Breaking the Waves by Lars von Trier, the song appears when the young husband Jan had an accident, so his wife Bess has to decide to what extent is important their marriage to her. So the song is about a complete change, when we can turn our whole life upside down to achieve some serious thing. For what is worth living, moreover, for what is worth to die.